Hello everyone, welcome back to Sun Innovative YouTube channel, and we are back with a new video on a series of type choppers. And today video is a type D chopper, and the also known as the first and fourth quadrant converter. It means that our simulation will be work on a first and fourth quadrant. So let us start with the theory. So I am explaining the theory first. So this is the type D chopper, you can see here. This is the circuit diagram, this is the quadrant operation of circuit diagram, and this is the waveform of this circuit diagram. So let us start with the circuit diagram explanation. So VS, it is a input supply, you can see here. This is the source voltage, and CH1, it is a thyristor operated and force commutated device. And box line, it is also indicated as a force devices. And without the box line, you can assume that this switch is doesn't have the force commutation. So while drawing the circuit diagram, it is important to draw the box also, because it indicate the force commutation. And this is the load which is connected with the two limb, right? And D1 and D2 is connected like this way. And this is the again second switch, CH2. So you can see this is the not complementary switch actually. In a last video type C chopper, we have observed that CH1 and CH2 both will be a complementary switch. And you can see here the stress of the input supply is divided into these two switches, CH1 and CH2, because it is connected in the first quadrant. And you can see whenever the stress is going to applied with these all four devices, so it will be equally divided in a four power electronic switch. So in this D chopper, voltage stress is reduces. And you can check the quadrant operation of this type D chopper. So you can see here our quadrant operation state that the output voltage remain in a positive and negative, but current will be remain in always in a positive condition. So there is a alpha is here. It state that the duty cycle, it is state that the if you increase the 0.5 duty cycle, so you will be run your converter in a first quadrant. If you reduce the duty cycle below the 0.5 values, you can run your converter in a fourth quadrant. It means that if you have the duty cycle above the 0.5 values, so you will be get the positive voltage and positive current. And if you run your simulation below the 0.5 value, so your output voltage will be a negative and output current will be in a positive always. So you can check the waveform here. So you can see this is the output voltage of the different duty cycle. You can see this is the 80% of duty cycle and this is the 20% of duty cycle, because on period in a here waveform you can check this is the more, and on period of this circuit it is a lesser than the T off time, you can check here. But the magnitude of output voltage, you can see this is the positive and this is the negative, so it goes in a both magnitude, positive and negative, you can check here. But current remains in a positive above the x-axis, you can check here. It is in a continuous conduction mode, you can check this one. And this is nothing else, this we have to prove in a simulation that our output voltage is in a positive and negative, and current remains in always in a positive. So let us start the simulation. So this is already developed, the type D chopper simulation, and all component you can find in a Simulink library browser. You can find by clicking this this symbol. And these two switches we have connected S1 and S2 as per the theory and diagram. And in between these two limb, we have connected the RLE motor load, and this both are output current and voltage measurement purpose. And you can see the arrangement of PWM signals here. And as we know that the both switches are not the complementary switch, it means that we can apply the same gate pulse which is generated by the PWM arrangement. So you can see the IG1 and IG1 both same gate pulse we have provided to the same switch S1 and S2, and D1 and D2 anti-parallel diode is connected across the S1 and S2 switches there. So this is the input DC supply source is there. And now we will going to run the simulation. So as usual, I have written here the infinite time to observe the live runtime simulation, and we can observe the output voltage while changing the duty cycle on a runtime. So I'm running this simulation, and to observe the output voltage, I'm opening the scope here. You can check this is the scope output voltage. Now you can check this one. So let me explain the converter output voltage first. So you can see this is the output voltage of converter. So you can easily observe that the output voltage is goes positive and negative magnitude. You can check the y axis here, 100 voltage and minus 100 voltage. And if you are not able to read this value, you can improve the quality of this video and you can check the values, and you can these values will be readable when we improve the quality videos. You can select the settings from the YouTube. And this is the second graph which is show the output current, and it is under the discontinuous conduction mode because it reaches the zero values. And now it is time to change the duty cycle by changing the slider gain value. So let me open the first slider gain and we will observe that how the effect we can observe after changing the duty cycle. So now it was the running on a 0.2 duty cycle, and if I'm going to change the duty cycle like this way, I'm increasing the duty cycle. So you can observe the effect of output voltage and the output current you can see. So if I'm increasing the duty cycle, so you can see the current is also, magnitude is also going to improve, and there will be a change in output voltage also because it shows the back EMF value like this way. And inductor is also connected, so some spikes will be obviously there. And now you can check the increasing in the magnitude of current by increasing in a magnitude of duty cycle. So you can see here, so I'm increasing the duty cycle to observe that what will happen. So you can see here, now your current is become the continuous conduction mode. You can see it left the zero values and goes to the upward direction. And this is the converter output voltage, you can check here. And this is the all about, you can see the magnitude is, output voltage is 100 voltage and minus 100 voltage. It means that positive and negative values, and output current is remaining in a positive in all duty cycle which we have selected for the changes. So this is all about the type D chopper, and this is the verification and proven theory. That let me compare the theory and practical simulated result here. So you can see here the output voltage first graph, this state that the output voltage simulated result here, and this is the output current which is shows the positive magnitude here, and this is the nothing else, this is the verification. And let me show you once again the quadrant operation. You can see here, when we increase the duty cycle beyond the 0.5 values, so it will give the positive output voltage and negative output voltage, but current remained in a positive way only. So this is the verification of class D chopper, and this is a very important class D chopper because when we practically connected the motor load across this type D chopper, so it state that your motor will be run in a first quadrant, that is a forward motoring, and the fourth quadrant it stored that reverse braking. So this is the verification and simulated result, you can check here. So thank you guys, thank you very much for showing this video and to support this channel. So please like and share and subscribe, so it will help a lot. Thank you guys, thank you very much.